Hey guys, it's Renee. So for these earrings, I'm going to be using some porcelain clay. Feel free to use polymer clay if you prefer. I just prefer to work with this kind of clay because it hardens with air, which means that I don't have to bake anything. And this is what it looks like. And I'm going to be rolling this over a piece of wax paper using this roller that has like those two rings, green rings on each side. Those are there just so that I can have the same thickness all throughout my clay. I'm going to be using this baking tool. It's my piping tool, Wilton 1M. It's a quickie cut. Just to cut two circles, and I'm going to be cleaning after this. I'm going to be taking one of those circles and I'm going to be folding this like a mini taco, just because I want to cut this in half with my X-Acto knife. And by folding this, everything is going to be more even. Folding that in half again, cutting it with my X-Acto knife. So I'm going to be taking two of those, like one quarter, like the tiny parts, and I'm going to be rolling them into like spheres. I'm going to be taking two halves, turning them again into mini spheres. I'm going to be taking this to ear posts. I'm just going to be cutting this. And then I have a chain here. I think the name of this chain is like box chain. So I'm just going to cut like two pieces. Now it's time to bring everything together. Remember, my clay hardens with air, so it's not fully dry yet. It's getting dry on the outside, soft on the inside. So what I have here is my chain. My earring, my dotting tool that I do have the DIY on, can be used for many things, but I'm going to be using this to make holes with it, and a sewing pin. I'm going to be wrapping my bigger bead, and I'm going to be making holes with my tool, just so that I can place my chain through that hole. If you go directly with your chain, because it's not like round and perfect, you know what I mean, can ruin the shape. So I'm going to be taking my other like smaller bead, and I'm going to be making again another hole, and then just placing like the other side of my chain. I'm going to be taking my pin, making a tiny hole on the back of it, and then in goes my earring part. If you're working with clay, first make all the holes. Once your pieces are baked, you can attach like the chain and the earrings. To paint this, I'm going to be using some gold acrylic paint, my brush, and I'm going to be painting the chain. Because I didn't have the chain in gold, I'm going to be painting the same black. This tool comes in handy. In this case, I'm going to be using this to paint first around the chain part, because I don't want to stain my gold chain, and I didn't have my like detailed brushes. And then I'm going to be grabbing my brush, and I'm going to be covering the whole thing in black, giving this a couple of coats until it's like opaque. But yeah guys, these are the earrings that I want to share with you. Honestly, I love them. They're really cute. I think they look fancy, like a subtle statement. It's a good option for when you want to wear gold but you don't want to go all out with gold. These earrings though look amazing with like halter tops. They are pretty lightweight, pretty easy to make, affordable to make as well, and I really hope you like them. If you did, don't forget to give this a thumbs up. Check out more accessories that I have on my channel. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you later and take care. Bye!